ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a great thing and very simple, which is dhikrullahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Islam, we have many things to do. Salah, zakah, hajj, umrah, qiyam al-layl. But the easiest thing, dhikrullahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the sahaba, رضي الله تعالى عنه، ألم نبئكم بخير أعمالكم وأزكاها عند مليككم وأرفعها في درجاتكم وخير لكم من إنفاق الذهب والورق، وخير لكم من أن تلقوا عدوكم فتضربوا أعناقهم وتضرب أعناقهم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to the Sahaba, do you like to tell you about a deed, a type of worship? It is the best. And it will take you to the highest level in Jannah. Make you very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is better than giving charity from gold and silver, الذهب والورق. And also it is better than jihad. The Sahab said, yes, tell us. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, dhikrullah. To remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very easy. What you need? How much you need to pay to do this type of worship, dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Nothing. If you are at home, in your car, in your job, any place, you can make dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the habit of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يذكر الله على جميع أحيانه. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to make dhikr anytime, any place. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تلهكم أموالكم ولا أولادكم عن ذكر الله ومن يفعل ذلك فأولئك هم الخاسرون. Or who believe, let not your wealth or your children divert you from the ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى. If any act thus, the severe loss is their own. You lose yourself if you miss dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُوا قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُوا الْقُلُوبُ. Those who believe, their hearts find satisfaction in dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For without doubt, only in the dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala do hearts find satisfaction. Many people suffer, many people have depression, anxiety, they fear for the future. If you have dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you do dhikr all the time, inshallah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the security. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove from your heart this fear from the future. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُ الْقُلُوبِ.
If anything happens to you, any مصيبة, any big problem came to you, you should say إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة. If any problem came to you, you should say إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. اللهم أجرني في مصيبتي واخلف لي خيرا منها. Allah سبحانه وتعالى will give you better than what he take from you. سبحانه وتعالى. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said ومن يعش عن ذكر الرحمن نقيض له شيطان فهو له قرين. And now the opposite. If you did not remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى, what will happen? Why many people suffer? Allah سبحانه وتعالى said ومن يعش عن ذكر الرحمن. If anyone withdraws himself from dhikr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from dhikr Rahman, he doesn't pray. He doesn't make dhikr. He doesn't say anything after the salah. He doesn't say anything before sleeping or when he wakes up. He doesn't know the sunnah about dhikr. Just he wants to play and enjoy his life. وَمَنْ يَعْشُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ الرَّحْمَانِ. If anyone withdraws himself from dhikr Rahman, we appoint for him a shaitan to be an intimate companion with him, to him. Subhanallah, the shaitan will be with him. And if you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. So if you did not mention the remember Allah, shaitan will be with you all the time. And subhanAllah, if you remember Allah, Allah will be with you. So you can choose. You like to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or with the shaitan. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me, I remember you. What are the benefits from dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There are a lot of benefits. I will mention a few of them. Number one, as I mentioned, the ayah, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me and I will remember you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with you. Allah will protect you from car accident. Allah will protect you from the evil eye. Allah will protect you from the evil people. Allah will protect you from magic. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep you very close to him in Firdaus al-A'la, inshallah. More dhikr guarantees immunity from hypocrisy. Al-munafiqun, hypocrites, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but very little. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. So if you remember Allah very little, it means you are like the munafiqeen, like the hypocrites. So remember Allah more, this will be immunity for you to be among the hypocrites. And what is the meaning of ذكر الله كثيرا? Some scholars said, to be among them, if you pray the five prayers, and you say adhkar in the day and afternoon, adhkar al-sabah al-masa, and you say the dhikr after the salah, and you say dhikr before sleeping, you say dhikr after sleeping. As total, this will not take 20 minutes or 25 minutes. You will be among those al-dhakirin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kathiran wa al-dhakirat. Very easy. It is very easy. Also, one of the benefits for dhikr, it will give you the power. Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, the daughter of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, was suffering because of working. She doesn't have anyone to help her at home. So she went to her father Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and she complained, I am working alone. I need help. I need a slave. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do you like what is better than a slave? Say before sleeping, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah, 33 times. Alhamdulillah, 33 times. Allahu Akbar, 34 times. So the total, 100 times. It is only 1 minute. This is better than a servant or a slave. Subhanallah. Also, dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you from the shaitan. And the famous hadith, when the Prophet said to Abu Huraira, who will take the money of the Muslim Ummah, Bayt Mal Muslimin, like Bayt al-Zakah, the money of the Muslims. So Abu Huraira saw a man at night stealing from the money. Then he caught this man, and he was a shaitan, subhanAllah. He was a shaitan. And the shaitan taught Abu Huraira what to say before sleeping, then Allah will protect you. Recite Ayatul Kursi. Recite Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. The ayah, Allah will protect you the whole night. Subhanallah. Even from thieves, even from shaitan, even from sihr. From everything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. Also, if you recite the last two ayah from Surah Al-Baqarah, آمن رسول بما أنزل إليه ربي والمؤمنون. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. And of course, this is the best dhikr, Al-Qur'an Al-Azim. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يغفر لنا ذنوبنا جزاكم الله خير صلى الله عليه وسلم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى very easy and very important. If you remember Allah, means you are alive. If you don't remember Allah, you are dead. You are not with us. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مثل الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكر ربه كمثل الحي والميت. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the example of one who remembers Allah, who remembers his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one who doesn't remember him is like that of the living and dead. Subhanallah. If you remember Allah, you are alive. If you don't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, imagine yourself or consider yourself, you are enslaved in the grave. Subhanallah. The benefits of dhikrullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will end with this dhikr. If you say subhanallah after the salah, after the fard salah, subhanallah 33 times. Alhamdulillah 33 times. Allahu Akbar 33 times. He who recites after every prayer subhanallah 33 times. Alhamdulillah 33 times. Allahu Akbar 33 times. And completes the 100th. It means that one time you say لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. If Allah سبحانه وتعالى will forgive all of his sins, even if the sins like the foam of the sea, Allah will forgive. It means Allah will forgive all of your sins. How much this will take from you? How many minutes? Even if you want to go, if you are in a hurry after the salah, say this dhikr when you are walking or in your car. Don't miss this dhikr, because the shaitan tells you immediately after the salah, yalla, go to the jam'iyyah, go to your family quickly, you are busy. And subhanallah, this how many minutes will take from you? Only 1 minute. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all of your sins. So be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will be with you. If we say, why I'm feeling sad, I don't know, I'm depressed, I don't know, because we are very far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we should make dhikr all the time. We teach our children and family to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will be with you. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الاحياء منهم والاموات انك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. اللهم احبب الينا الايمان وزيد